Romans 8, 26 and 27.
In the same way, the Spirit also helps our weakness. For we do not know how to pray as we should, but the Spirit Himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. And He who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because He intercedes for the saints according to the will of God.
Instead of blah blah, why can't we sit quiet in God's presence?
When I sit quiet, they ask, what happened to you? your mood is off. Sometimes my mood is off, but most of the time, certain prayer meetings, not all. Then I get confused.
A bishop once went to meet an Abba, patriarch, bunch of people. Went in the morning, sat with him, and no certain teachings from him. He sat silent for throughout morning till noon. The servant came and said, Abba, bishop is waiting to hear from you. Abba said, if he cannot understand my silence, he cannot understand my words. He was communicating. It looks strange. Psalm 19, 1 to 3.
The heavens are telling the glory of God, and their expanse is declaring the work of His hands. Day to day pours forth speech, and night to night reveals knowledge. There is no speech, nor are these their words. Their voice is not heard.
How does the voice then heard throughout the world? Without words, without speech, how is it spoken? This is where we have been learning from beginning, listen to the silence of God also. Every time we need not say so many things. Let the Spirit intercede for us. When you know clearly, pray. If you don't know, silence. Father, you always hear me. For their sake, I am saying this prayer. He says, I don't need to pray, but for their sake only I am praying. You will be thought by, it's inevitable. If you join the crowd, you are normal. Why don't you accept it? Nobody will understand you. That is another way of ridiculing you, to make you irritated, so that you will join with them. He instructs me in my sleep. Have you heard the instructions? God speaks one way or other way. Many people do not listen. Job 33, 14 to.
For God speaks in one way, and in two, though man does not perceive it.
Continue, 15 to 18.
In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falls on men, while they slumber on their beds, then He opens the ears of men and terrifies them with warnings, that He may turn man aside from his deed and conceal pride from a man. He keeps back his soul from the pit, his life from perishing by the sword.
19 onwards.
Man is also rebuked with pain on his bed and with continual strife in his bones, so that his life loathes bread and his appetite the choicest food. His flesh is so wasted away that it cannot be seen, and his bones that were not been sick were not seen stick out. His soul draws near the pit, and his life to those who bring death.
Yes, that's another way of speaking. Yes, many ways he can speak. Do we listen? Yes, this is a difficulty. Psalm 32, 8 and 9, there are two ways of speaking.
I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will guide you with my eye. Do not be like the horse or like the mule, which have no understanding, which must be harnessed with bit and bridle, else they will not come near you.
Yes, this two many ways of speaking. The new covenant is, I will keep my law within their heart, nobody need to teach. Do we listen to that inside? The kingdom of God is within you. The laws are written inside us. Do we listen? Hebrews 10 chapter 16 to 18. Same thing comes in Jeremiah and Ezekiel. Jeremiah 31, 33. Jeremiah 31, 33 and 34.
Behold, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. Not like the covenant that I made with their fathers on the day when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt. My covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, declares the Lord. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, declares the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people.
34.
And no longer shall each one teach his neighbor and each his brother, saying, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, declares the Lord, for I will forgive their iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more.
Read from Hebrews 10, chapter 16 to 18.
This is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, declares the Lord. I will put my laws on their hearts and write them on their minds. Then he adds, I will remember their sins and their lawless deeds no more. Where there is forgiveness of these, there is no longer any offering for sin.
Yes. Now the laws are written in your heart. John Stott writes, Kingdom of God is within you means the laws are already written there. Natural laws are written there, you cannot do anything against it. Moral laws are also written. Do we listen to it? You cannot live under water. You cannot. You cannot break the law. You have to live honoring the gravity. You cannot jump from there and say gravity doesn't matter. So, similarly, moral laws cannot be violated. There will be consequence. It's written, you know that. We purposefully break it.